Okay, I'm going to call the meeting to order, the regular town board meeting. Before we stand for the pledge, I just want to make a couple of comments. One, after we have the pledge, I'd like to have a moment of silence, certainly in remembrance of the victims of the September 11th, having the 15th anniversary of that horrific event. It sort of brings home the focus of the challenges that our country faces and how important it is for us to be united together in protecting our democracy and the freedoms that we enjoy. And the second is a moment of silence for the passing of Joe Ward. Joe was a lifelong resident of Cornwall, involved in so many activities, and worked for the town as a building inspector for many, many years. Was a dispatcher, did so many different things for the community, and involved in the fire service, I think probably most of his adult life, holding various positions with the Highland Engine and with the county and all. So we'll begin with the Pledge of Allegiance and then just a moment of silence.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Okay, we have three public hearings scheduled beginning at 7 o'clock. And the first is on local law number 4. Please take notice the town board of the town of Cornwall will hold a continuation of a public hearing on the 12th day of September 2016, 7 o'clock p.m. at Town Hall 183 Main Street, Cornwall, New York, on proposed local law number 4 of the year 2016, entitled Local Law to Amend Town Code Chapter 158. Entitled Zoning to Change the Zoning Designation of Certain Real Property from Suburban Residence District 2 to Highway Commercial, and to change the zoning designation of other real property from Suburban Residence 2 to Planned Commercial Development. The purpose of this local law is to amend the town's zoning code to implement the provisions of the town's comprehensive plan by changing the zoning designation of certain real property from Suburban Residence District 2 to Highway Commercial, and by changing the zoning designation of certain real property from Suburban Residence 2 to planned commercial development. A copy of the proposed local law is on file in the office of the town clerk and available for inspection by interested persons during the town clerk's business hours. The town board will, at the above date, time, and place, hear all persons interested in the subject matter hereof. A person may appear in person or by agent. All written communication addressed to the board must be received by the board at or prior to the public hearing. By order of the town board, town of Cornwall, Renata McGee, town clerk. I'll now declare the public hearing open. Anyone wishing to speak on this matter, please give your name and address to the clerk. Yes. You please just stand. Yes.
Hi, everybody. Good evening. My name is Jay Zhang. I am the relatively new superintendent of New York Military Academy, NEMA. And tonight I'm here speaking on behalf of my school and the Board of Trustees to present our views to the proposed local law number 4. So I'll begin with an overview. New York Military Academy strongly recommends that voting on local law number 4 be delayed to allow for more time to develop a comprehensive approach to the rezoning of NEMA that better meets the current and future needs of the community and NEMA. We believe the new administration recently outreach with the community local economic investment to the tune of approximately $20 million and aggressive recruitment should dissuade this town board from strictly planning for NEMA's failure. Rather, this town board needs to be focusing on NEMA's success. Indeed.
Jay, excuse me, I just want to ask you, is this the what was submitted to the board today, the email that we received? It's about 5 pages long?
Nearly, yes.
Okay, it's not necessary to read the whole thing. We have copies of it that we will put into the minutes for it. So if you have any additional comments, we'd be happy to receive them.
Okay, so I will be brief.
Thank you.
So first point I want to make from the policy perspective is that we have done, we have made every effort on both domestic and international recruitment. Example includes a new hire of the Director of Admissions, who is a local Cornwall resident, who has been very experienced in education and who is now in charge of our domestic recruitment, which we are very happy about that. Internationally, we are a couple of us, including myself and my Director of Admissions, we are traveling internationally to recruit internationally. So that's just one big effort we want to let you know. Number two is that we've had, in the documents we received, appendix number one, we have had tremendous media attention, which I brought the updated appendix one with all the paper copies of the media reports.
Thank you.
That'll be a number two, the area that I want to mention. Number three, that I want to say that we've done, I think I started by saying $20 million, which means in addition to purchasing the property, the Board of Trustees has begun and has done number of capital improvements, including the $720,000 roof project, the Wi-Fi project, that is on the way, and we also are looking at renovating the barracks. Okay, so those are a few of the many capital planning that we have had, you know, we have begun to look at. Those are the couple of, just really in brief, you know, in short, those are the policy perspective I want to present to you. Again, it's detailed in the written document submitted to Supervisor Vendenzo. May I invite one of the Board of Trustee members who will give you a little bit of on the legal perspective. Now, you know that I've been a long-term educator, nothing but education, so I don't want to pretend I know the legal impact on this, but I would just like to invite him to say a few words.
Sure. Okay? Stand up, just give your name, address
Hi,
to the clerk.
Hi, Joe Sapphire, a member of the Board of Trustees of a New York Military Academy. And yes, adding to the letter that we provided today, just really want to make, you know, 4 points on the overall, our analysis of local law number four, which we shared with the town attorney and which we shared with you during the working session, is that, you know, we understand that, you know, local law number four was based on the 2012, you know, comprehensive plan. And I think that, you know, it's clear that at that time there was anticipation that NEMA would close. And so that's, again, why we're reiterating that we're here and that is not the case. And that this zoning should contemplate NEMA continuing. You know, that's really necessary. And we've, you know, proposed several different amendments and several different ways in which that could be done in a proactive manner. And that's really why we're asking that you delay the vote so that we really have an opportunity to discuss this. And I know that our outside counsel has spoken with the town attorney, and we've heard, you know, from some of the town board members off the record that that they're looking for direction in terms of, you know, what the legal implications are of amending local law number four. And so that's really the critical reason to delay the vote, so that we have a time to discuss this. And you see, you know, from our actions, you know, by the new leadership, that we want to engage. You know, we're being thoughtful and we want to talk through these issues. And I think that you know, as has been stated, what local law number four does is, you know, makes NEMA a non-conforming use, requiring the zoning board of approval and planning board of approval. And, you know, and as was noted by the planning board, you know, this is an unnecessary, burdensome step, which would make sense if NEMA was closing, you know, and there was going to be development of the land on either side of 9W. But as you know, we're not closing. And so, you know, in the amendment that we proposed to make NEMA a conforming, to make NEMA conforming under a special use permit, you know, there was a question of, under highway commercial and planned commercial development zoning districts, the new proposed zoning districts under local law number four, that a special use permit wouldn't be admissible. That wouldn't be part of educational use. And we want to make the point that it is. So private schools like NEMA are consistent with the uses permitted in highway commercial and planned commercial development zoning districts. And so, you know, we think that that this should be reviewed in a comprehensive manner. And as we all know, you know, NEMA's history predates the town's zoning laws. And so there's questions in general about how NEMA should be zoned. And here we have a thoughtful leadership, a leadership who cares about the community, who wants to engage in a dialogue and do it in a professional manner, to think about what is best for NEMA now and into the future, and think about what is best for the town now into the future. So you have a willing partner here who would like to open a dialogue with you to make that happen, and we feel that it would be really short-sighted to pass a flawed law now to fix it later, right? To pass something incomplete now to fix it later. This law was developed and proposed in April when the new leadership, Jay, our new superintendent, she didn't come until July. So give her and give us the opportunity to talk through these issues, and that's what we're asking for. Just a simple request that we delay the vote so that we can have a further discussion.
Thank you.
I just have 30 seconds of my time out. I just felt to mention that I brought our new dean of academics, Dr. Jonathan Gestel, who has now joined me in the effort to turn NEMA around. And I must tell you that in the short 3 weeks that we've worked together, really we are starting to see real differences. So I really just want to ask everyone here, we kind of gave up something, you know, that was legal, very safe in Korea, to come here to really we want to be part of this history. So please give us time. That's all what we ask. Thank you.
Anyone else wishing to speak? Yes.
Yes, I apologize. It's a little late.
Yes. Just give your name and address to the clerk.
My name is Ann Harold Brizzoli. I live at 3 Duggan Lane in Cornwall on Hudson. I have a statement to read on behalf of a neighbor of mine who could not be here tonight, and he asked me to read it on his behalf. His name is David Redden. He lives on Deer Hill. I don't have his exact address, but he's a resident on Deer Hill, and he is busy elsewhere. Dear Town Board, please do not let NEMA down. An unlikely champion arrived in Cornwall to save something everyone considered unsalvageable, and has poured enormous resources into the enterprise. Please don't let NEMA down. Between purchase price and projected deficit for the first year's operation, nearly $20 million will have been spent on NEMA and NEMA's recovery. This is an amazing investment in our community. Please don't let NEMA down. You see, there's a thing. Jay Chang is a brilliant high-powered educator and has been appointed superintendent, and she is enthusiastically building a dedicated and equally brilliant staff. Please don't let NEMA down. Yet Local Law 4 essentially says that NEMA should not exist. That NEMA founded here in Cornwall in 1889 is a mistake. That NEMA's use of their property for its school does not represent what our community wants the property used for. Do you really want to let NEMA down? Do you really want to discourage the school from achieving its rebirth? Please don't let NEMA down. That was from David Redden at 80 Deer Hill Road, village and town property owner.
Thank you.
I'd like to add my comment, if I may,
sure,
from my husband, who is Bill Brizzoli, G-R-I-S-O-L-I. We are relatively new here. We moved here last summer. We were unaware of the zoning interest in this area and surrounding areas. We're well aware of it now. And we also feel that this proposed law should maybe be held in abeyance for a period of time while we see what the new governing body at NEMA is able to do. And we could readdress this at a later time when we see how NEMA succeeds or does not. We feel that if we pass this law now, it would be an unnecessary burden on the new folks that came in as they tried to assist.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Hearing no one from the public, I know our attorney has written a memo to the board, which give an overview for the on the record.
Sure, I handed it in at the workshop. I'm assuming the town clerk has a copy of it as well. The comprehensive plan for the town of Cornwall has a very clear directive as far as Route 9W commercial corridor, it's called, that northern area abutting New Windsor. And that is commercial development. Allows for the planned adult community of the Cornwall Commons proposed project, which is, I think the board is familiar, has a large commercial ring along the outside of it, office space, retail. I believe a hotel is even proposed there. And the idea is to have kind of a mirror image of that on the other side of 9W, which happens to be, now at least, where NEMA is located. I don't think that there's a lot of dispute that the commercial zoning is what's called for or even what's appropriate as far as, this is all in my memo and set forth with citations and the like. The only issue is that under the existing residential zoning, schools are permitted as special permit uses, subject to site plan approval as well, whereas no commercial district in the town of Cornwall allows schools, private schools, by special permit, site plan, or otherwise. Our zoning scheme just doesn't provide for it. Now, NEMA has existed in the town, as gone over a number of times, for many, many years, probably later on. But NEMA has never gotten a special use permit, nor has it ever gotten site plan approval. It predates zoning. Therefore, NEMA, as we sit here today, is a legal non-conforming use. If NEMA wanted to make changes, it would have to go to the zoning board and the planning board, right now under existing zoning. The new zoning coming into place will leave NEMA in exactly the same position it is in now. The zoning change doesn't require NEMA to leave, doesn't require NEMA to shut down, doesn't impede NEMA to do anything that it could do right now under existing zoning. Now, I suppose in theory that they could go in and apply for a special permit, site plan, and that would be the difference between the two as far as the zoning change goes. The town board has indicated before that it'll continue a dialogue with NEMA, and if this is truly something NEMA feels strongly about, that perhaps a change could be made down the road as far as that goes. Certainly NEMA's free to petition for a zoning change. They think it should be permitted by special permit in commercial districts. They can propose that. The town board, if it wants, can take up that issue. But this zoning change will put your zoning into conformance with your comprehensive plan. And as I said, I mean, it's not like NEMA's proposing to go to the planning board now or zoning or anything like that. I mean, if you want to work out something in the future, you have plenty of time going forward under the correct zoning to make whatever change you feel is appropriate. But that's all the memo says. The decision, of course, lies with the board. You have to use your judgment as to whether it's appropriate to hold off and pursue something else or go forward or something like.
Thank you, Steve. Okay, hearing no one else, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Move and second. Discussion. Roll call.
Discussion. I think this is a very hostile move against NEMA. We had plenty of time since April, since July, when the planning board gave us the memorandum suggesting that we modify the zoning so that when we change it, that we give NEMA every opportunity to be in a non-conforming position. When you ran for town board supervisor last year, you were very pleased to be able to say that Randy Clark had a horrible reputation and a horrible relationship with NEMA, and the first thing out the gate that you do is you put us in an awkward position. And I think that we have a couple of months. There's no hurry, there's no rush to do public law number 4. We can find and modify the zoning so that they're in a non-conforming situation and that we give them every opportunity to succeed. And I think this has really been rushed. I disagree with it completely, and I think that this is a very bad first step for our relationship with NEMA for all of the reasons that Joa has cited. In addition to the fact that This is the first opportunity we've seen since I've lived here for a real success story with NEMO. And having outside investors come in and be welcomed is a really good way to project that Cornwall is open for business, that Cornwall is friendly to outside interests, to outside investors, and we really should not be passing a law that is incomplete and does not take into account the needs of one of what is going to certainly be one of our major employers. So I would strongly suggest that we do not vote in favor of this, that we table this and give it a few months, change the zoning, and embrace NEMA into our community.
Well, just to comment on that, I will tell you we have embraced NEMA. This is not anti-NEMA, despite what you might portray it to be. This is a matter of the town looking at the zoning, and the zoning is based on the best interests of the community first. Secondly, the town board has worked on this zoning to put in place what we hope would be something that, in the event that NEMA is not successful, and we hope they are successful for another 128 years, but in the event that they aren't successful, that certainly there would be other options for the town in terms of development of commercial properties that could bring jobs into the community as well as rateables for some tax relief. So this is not hostile, this is not anti-NEMA. Secondly, the board tonight, after we close the public hearings and we get into the agenda, we'll have a resolution on the action. The board can then vote on the adoption of the resolution. But I will say certainly for the record that if the board does adopt this zoning change, this is not the end of considering zoning issues. It's been said by someone who's very well versed in government and zoning and planning that the moment you adopt a change in the zoning is the day that you begin looking at the next step. It's not an it's a work that's in progress. So I mean, I want to assure NEMA and the public that if the board does adopt this tonight, that is not the end of discussion, but the beginning of the discussion, based on specifically things like special use permit, which has come up in the past few weeks, so that we have an opportunity to examine in depth what a special use permit for a private school would be, and also to look at all the districts, the zoning districts throughout the town, to find out how it's incorporated. So the focus is on making these zoning changes now, and then we will engage, if the board approves this, we will then engage with NEMA through the attorneys and through our planner to give a complete review as to what they're proposing. And if they wanted to submit, as Mr. Gavis said, they can submit a request for a zoning change, or the town could take it on themselves. But it's going to give us more of an opportunity to delve into what impact those changes may have on the community. So it is not a hostile, and you shouldn't portray it as being hostile in any way, Mr. Summerfield. It is not hostile.
It is absolutely.
This is the business of the town.
In that case, if you put it on hold for a few months until we work out all the arrangements, and then we can pass it.
I think the board will make a decision when we get to the agenda, and you can make your comments if you have further comments at that time. Moving to the second, roll call on closing the public hearing.
Mr. Russell.
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis.
Yes.
Ms. Bunt.
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield.
Yes.
Mr. Rendesky.
Yes, motion is carried. The next public hearing is on local law number 5. Please take notice the town board of town of Cornwall will hold a continuation of a public hearing on 12th day of September 2016, 7 o'clock p.m. at Town Hall 183 Main Street, Cornwall, New York. I propose local law number 5 of the year 2016 entitled A Local Law to Amend Town Code Chapter 158 entitled Zoning. To add certain uses to the uses permitted in the planned residential development district as alternatives to planned adult communities. The proposed local law, the purpose of this local law is to implement the provisions of the town's comprehensive plan by amending the use table for the planned residential development district, adding uses permitted in the planned commercial development to the uses permitted in the PRD district as alternatives to planned adult community. A copy of the proposed local law is on file in the office of the town clerk and available for inspection by interested persons during town clerk's business hours. Town board will, at the real date, time, and place, hear all persons interested in the subject matter thereof. Persons may appear in person or by agent. All written communication addressed to the board must be received by the board at or prior to the public hearing by order of the town board, town of Cornwall, Renata McGee, town clerk. Just basically what this local law The change of zoning is on the Cornwall Commons property, the western side of Route 9W, is to actually add more options for different types of development. Right now, it's pretty much limited to a planned adult community, but this will broaden the possibility to do highway commercial and planned commercial development, which is a mirror image of what the zoning is proposed for the eastern side of Route 9W. I'll declare the public hearing open. Any wishing to speak on this proposed zoning change? I'll ask again, anyone wishing to speak on this proposed zoning change? Hearing no one, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Undesser?
Yes, motion is carried. And the final public hearing tonight is on a vehicle and traffic amendment. Please take notice. Town Board of Town of Cornwall hold a public hearing on the 12th day of September 2016 at 7 o'clock p.m. Town Hall 183 Main Street, Cornwall, New York, on a proposed local law entitled A Local Law to Amend Town Code Chapter 143 entitled Vehicles and Traffic. The local law would amend Section 143-30, Schedule 7, Section 143-31, Schedule 8, and Section 143-32, Schedule 9. In addition, stop signs will be placed at several new locations. A copy of the proposed local law is on file in the office of the town clerk and available for inspection by interested persons during the town clerk's business hours. Town board will at the above date, time, and place hear all persons interested in the subject matter hereof. A person may appear in person by agent or written communications addressed to the board must be received by the board at or prior to the public hearing. By order, town board, town of Cornwall, Renata McGee, town clerk. This pertains to a restricted parking safety zone on Bridge Street. In that short section from Main Street to where the road is blocked off, and also two stop signs that are proposed. One is Clara Street at the intersection of Holloman Road and Station Road at the intersection of Star Road. Declare the public hearing open. Anyone wishing to speak for or against these proposed zoning or V&T amendments? I'll ask again, anyone wishing to speak on this proposed V&T amendment? Hearing no one, is a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Moved. Second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Undesser?
Yes. Motion is carried. Now I ask for approval of minutes of the August 1st, 2016 special meeting and August 8th, 2016 regular meeting. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Undesser?
Yes. Motion is carried. Before we get to public comment on agenda items, I just want to mention two things. I want to thank the Cornwall Chamber for the concert series that they put on over the summer. It was a great success for the community. The turnout was phenomenal of the residents coming out to really enjoy the music. So it was really a plus event for the community. And the second was the car show, which was a first for the community. The chamber put on a very successful car show where they had Saturday night cruisers who are the car show people who helped the chamber with it. And I think we had about 125 cars and a lot of people came during the day. So they're really two great events that the chamber sponsored. And so we really want to express our appreciation to the chamber. Have public comment on agenda items? Anyone wishing to speak on any agenda item? Okay, hearing no one.
She wants the girls who like to.
I'm going to read your letter and you can come on up. I'm going to actually, there's two things I'm moving up on the agenda so the board knows. Number one is the Cornwall Girl Scouts on a flower project, and then second will be the zombie walk. So I have a letter from Robin on the Girl Scout Troop 48 working on our Agent of Change journey. And they'd like to have permission from the board to create a 9-by-12-foot garden. But why don't you all come forward and just tell the board exactly what you're proposing? Come right up. There you go.
I
of Brownies juniors and soon-to-be cadets from Troop 48.
We are working on a project that will help our environment and will be a multi-year project.
The main reason to make this project is to help our younger scouts learn the laws, but it can also be for the older scouts to help them.
We are asking for a 9x12 space, and we designed what we want to use it as. We want some flowers and kind of our general idea of where we want to put stuff, and maybe we're going to get the older kids to build a walkway here, and we're going to add bird baths and different kinds of stuff to make it more like flower and more enjoyable for people to see.
We will start by killing off the poison ivy in the place that we would like to plant the flowers.
We will be tiling and embedding the soil.
We will add a fence and start planting tulips and clover.
So we wanted to show you what it would look like, and we placed mostly all the flowers we were going to use, and we put them out in colors to see, and we have different types of them. And we have daisies, we're going to add that one because they're daisies, and we want this to go on all year, like every year, so people could, like, all ages, daisies, cadets, juniors, could participate and make this a fun group project to work on.
Terrific.
We want to do it at the... We want to do it at the Girl Scout Cabin.
Okay. That's a very appropriate place.
Way in the back. And any questions?
Well, it sounds like a terrific project that would really certainly enhance and make the area a little more beautiful and give you a project. And I think it's something that we certainly would look forward to having you do for the scouts and for the community to be able to enjoy that. So the only thing I will say is before you get started, if there's poison ivy, let us know.
Right.
We'll get rid of the poison ivy before you go to work over there. So I'll ask for a motion of the town board to approve the project for the scouts.
So moved.
Second.
Moved. Second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell.
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis.
Yes.
Ms. Bunk.
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield.
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo.
Yes. And I thank you very much for coming and making the presentation, and good luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
How cute is that? That's not easy at that age, doing that.
That's why I like to have them come in the meeting and stand up and make the presentation. It's a good experience for them.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, next is a request that we have from Abigail Moore. We discussed it at our work session regarding the what's been referred to as the annual zombie walk. This year, instead of actually doing a walk, they're looking to use the ambulance building, the meeting room, and the outside to have an event. Basically, would be on October 22nd from 5 to 9. Participants would remain on the property. Certificate of insurance has been provided. And the zombies will purchase flags for $1. And if the hunter obtained the flag, the zombies go back and purchase another flag for $1 and no longer participate in the activity. We're also going to have a kid-friendly movie. During this time period as well, for those who no longer want to participate or take a break from the activity, asking the town board for approval. I think Eric was here, but he left.
There's Eric.
And Eric had explained that this is going to take place in the meeting room and outside, and has assured us that they will have monitors to make sure that the kids that are participating don't stray into the road or parking areas and just keep them in safe areas. So is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Okay. Now going to the agenda. Number one is a resolution, adoption of local law number 4 in the zoning. Whereas the town board has considered the adoption of a local law entitled A Local Law to Amend Town Code Chapter 158 entitled Zoning, to change the zoning designation of certain real property from suburban residence District 2, SR2, to Highway Commercial HC, and to change the zoning designation of other real property from suburban residence District 2, SR2, to Planned Commercial Development, PCD. Whereas following due notice, the town board held a public hearing on the proposed local law, now therefore be resolved as follows. The town board does hereby adopt the above local law, which said law shall be effective upon publication, posting, and filing in the office of the Secretary of State in Albany. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion?
Two points I'd like to
make. Go ahead, Peter.
We've already heard from the attorney on this on numerous occasions. The barrier doesn't get raised, nor is it any change from the previous barrier that already exists in the current zoning. And secondly, if we read on page 2 of the attorney's letter, under New York State law, the provisions of Town Code 158-27 and the general rule regarding variances do not apply to schools and churches. Instead, New York State law requires quote-unquote special treatment for schools and churches under which a request from a school or a church for land use approvals to build, enlarge, alter, extend, reconstruct, or restore structures must be granted unless the proposed construction is shown to endanger the public health, safety, or welfare. So we've gone over this over and over again. Not only is the barrier not being raised, they are entitled to special treatment that our other taxpayers or other businesses do not get in this town. We're not raising the barrier, we're not making it any harder, and they're still entitled to special treatment under the law. So I don't appreciate the characterization that it's some kind of hostile action by this town. And there was no discord before. I hope you're not bringing discord into the town. Because again, let's stick to the facts. And the facts are the barrier is not being raised. So I'm in favor of the motion.
Any other comment?
Now, this is an opportunity to raise the barrier, to make it easier for them and to embrace their movement into the community.
Well, the only
there's undue haste in this matter. It's much easier to make modifications, to allow them to not become non-conforming, and to welcome them into the community.
Actually, it is by taking this first step, we are really defining what the zoning is going to be for that property, and it then gives us the opportunity to discuss in further detail what changes we might want to consider. And two, there is maybe one misunderstanding, and that is, I think it's been referred to as having to go to the planning board and then having to go to the zoning board. But unless I'm incorrect, Mr. Gabbett, in most instances, they would go for site plan approval.
I think they have to go for site plan approval no matter what.
Yeah, that's already in place. So we're not forcing them to go. They still have to do all their plans, make all their presentations, take it to the planning board. The trip to the, as Councilman Russell said, if they have to go to the ZBA for a variance, it's a very simple process for schools and churches. So it doesn't, it's not going to hamper them in any of their ideas. And again, I'm going to emphasize, we are glad that NEMA is there. We are going to work with them to, hopefully see that they succeed. So it's not a barrier, and our line of communication will remain open. So any other comments? Roll call vote.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Abstain.
Mr. Summerfield?
No.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, the motion is carried. I have a resolution on local law number 5 on the zoning, whereas the town board has considered the adoption of local law entitled the local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to add certain uses to the uses permitted in the planned residential development district as alternatives to planned adult communities. And whereas the following due notice, the town board held a public hearing on the proposed local law, now therefore be resolved and follows, that the town board does hereby adopt the above local law, which said local law shall be effective upon publication, posting, and filing in the office of the Secretary of State in Albany. Is there a motion on the local law?
So
resolution.
Moved.
Second.
Moved and second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next is a resolution on local law number 6, whereas the town board has considered the adoption of local law entitled local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to revise certain definitions and the uses permitted in the agricultural, rural, Residence District and the Mountain Conservation Residence District. Whereas following due notice, the town board held a public hearing on the proposed local law, and therefore be resolved as follows, that the town board does hereby adopt the above local law, which said local law shall be effective upon publication, posting, and filing in the office of the Secretary of State. So a motion on the proposed local law?
So moved. Second.
Move, second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. The motion is carried. Next resolution is on the vehicle and traffic amendments. Whereas the town board has considered the adoption of local law number 7 of the year 2015 entitled a local law to amend town code chapter 143 entitled vehicles and traffic. Whereas the following, due notice, the town board held a public hearing on the proposed local law. And whereas the proposed local law is a type 2 action under SECRA and therefore be resolved as follows. The town board hereby adopts local law number 7 of the year 2016. Which said local law shall be effective upon publication, posting, and filing in the office of the Secretary of State in Albany. Is there a motion on the resolution?
Second.
Mm-hmm. Second.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. The motion is carried. Next, on the Economic Development Advisory Committee mission statement, the board has worked long and hard over several months to refine the mission statement, since this is really what we're hoping to be a more active economic development committee. And I think we've reached a point where we're pretty much satisfied with it. I'm going to read a resolution. Whereas the Economic Development Advisory Committee has proposed bylaws to establish its rules and procedures, and whereas the town board has before it revised bylaws incorporating all of the town board's changes, now therefore be resolved as follows. The town board hereby approves and adopts the revised EDAC bylaws, a copy of which is attached here too. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. And next, following up on the mission statements and bylaws, we reviewed again the Conservation Advisory Council bylaws, and I have a resolution. Whereas the Conservation Advisory Council, CAC, has proposed bylaws to establish its rules and procedures, and whereas the town board has before it the revised bylaws incorporating all of the town board changes, may therefore be resolved as follows, that the town board hereby approves and adopts the revised CAC bylaws, a copy of which is attached here too. Is there a motion on the resolution?
Second.
Move, second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. The motion is carried. We received the agreement for snow and ice control on county roads, certain county roads for 2016-17. And these are, the town actually does winter maintenance on 12.51 miles. I have a resolution regarding the proposal. Whereas the town of Cornwall has received an agreement for control of snow and ice on certain county roads for 2016-17, which obligates the town to remove snow and ice from county roads in return for a payment of $4,750 per mile for the designated roads. Whereas the town wishes to enter into the agreement with the county, now therefore be resolved as follows. One, town board hereby agrees to enter into the agreement for control of snow and ice on certain county roads listed on Schedule A annexed here to and made part of this resolution, and authorize the supervisor to execute the same. And two, the town agrees to provide the county with the required certificates of insurance together with the agreement executed by the supervisor. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Second. Moved, second by Helen. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next is the copy of the lease to the Postal Service for the Mountainville Post Office. It's exercise a renewal option. I think, Steve, you indicated to the board, the board really has to take no action because the Post Office is just telling us that they're exercising their rights to.
That's right. They have renew. The right to, they have the right to extend.
Okay. Now we're just going to note that for the record that we've received the renewal from the Post Office.
Mm-hmm.
Update on the KJ Wells Mountainville. We talked about this at the work session. I really just wanted to bring the public up to date. Back, I think, around June or so, the board authorized me to contact the village of Carrius, Joel, requesting approval and authorization for the town to have an independent contractor conduct tests on the well field to determine the safe yield of the wells. And I have been in touch with the Village of Cornwall Hudson and the town of Woodbury and the Village of Woodbury, as we've all been involved in this litigation with Carrier Oil over the Mountainville wells. And that litigation is separate from the annexation litigation. And we had a few pieces of correspondence go back and forth with the Village of Carrier Oil, and in the end, they basically said, unless we were willing to, our position was real simple. Let us have an independent contractor test the wells. If the wells prove to yield the 612,000 gallons per day safely that they claim that they do, then we would be willing to drop our lawsuit on the wells. And then our next step would be to, have adequate monitoring of the Woodbury stream and the wells that are in the area. Unfortunately, in the end, KRSJL told us that unless we were willing to drop not only the lawsuit on the Mountainville wells, but also the town's participation in the annexation lawsuit, that they would not be interested in allowing us to do any testing. So they never said they were going to approve it. They just said, we want you to say that you'll drop out of the lawsuit. So at this point, we really haven't been successful. I would have liked to have been successful, because I think we have questioned right along as to really whether that well field will really yield 612,000 gallons per day. So I just want to update everyone that we tried, and the village, even though they feel confident and they've convinced the DEC and the state that the yield is there, they will not let us, at our own expense, conduct our own independent testing of those wells to verify that yield. So it's unfortunate, but that's really where we're at. I have a resolution on a police traffic services grant. Whereas the Town of Cornwall Police Department has previously applied for a grant under the state's police traffic services program. Whereas the Town of Cornwall Police Chief has been notified by the New York State Governor's Traffic Safety Committee, the town's police department has been awarded a $4,500 grant to participate in said program. Therefore, be resolved as follows. One, that the town board hereby authorizes the chief of police to proceed with the grant acceptance procedures. And two, the town board authorizes supervisor and or chief to sign the appropriate grant acceptance documents. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rondezzo?
Yes, motion is carried. Next is a letter from our attorney advising the board that the Secretary of State has advised that local law number 3 of the year 2016 was filed in the Secretary's office on August 4th, 2016 and is now in effect. This is on the subdivision regulations pertaining to developers' security. Next is Metzcow drainage. This is drainage that the board was considering over the past couple of years. It was actually to construct a drainage system through two private properties. From one town road, which I believe was Alder, down through a vacant lot and through a developed property down on Shore. And went out there with Councilman McGinnis as a liaison to the highway and with our highway superintendent, Eugene Conley. And we took a look at the site and what was proposed. And a couple of things really stood out in reviewing the actual site. And the first is that we do not have any real drainage systems on Alder in that whole area, and a lot of the Beaver Dam area is on the side of a hill. The town has done nothing to change or alter the flow of water over that that area. And so when we looked at that and considered that there are probably other properties that are experiencing the same issues, it's kind of difficult for the town to go ahead and install a drainage system across those private properties. The second concern that I expressed was the fact that the vacant lot is a slope with trees, and apparently over the past 2 years since the town has been discussing this with the property owners, there's been a lot of dumping of debris on the property and branches and everything, but also just in consideration that this was being planned to be done in-house by our highway department, I don't believe that, considering that our highway department, our maintenance personnel, we have some very qualified people and good equipment operators, but they're really not construction type people. And I don't believe that this is a project that our employees should be taking on, given all the factors. So just want to.
There's also an existing water line there.
Correct. Which we found out as we were there. There's the, we've heard about the Beaver Dam, the private water system, and there's a water line which they estimate to be about 2 inches, it's speculation, that also crosses the property that would be involved with this drainage pipe having to go either above or below. So given the fact that the board has talked about it for the past 2 years or so, I'd just like to have a motion that we not proceed with the installation of that that drainage system.
So moved.
Moved. Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next is setting a public hearing for the benefit assessment districts. The districts are Cornwall Refuge District, Firthcliff Heights Water or Sewer District, Firthcliff Sewer District, Beaver Dam Lake Sewer District, Majestic Sewer District, Hidden Glen Drainage District, Main Street Parking District, and Stone Hollow Drainage District. The purpose of setting the public hearing is for property owners, if they feel that they're being unfairly assessed on those properties, it's an opportunity for them to come and address the board. So I propose that we set the public hearing for October 11th at 7 o'clock p.m. Is there a motion to set the public hearing?
So moved.
Is there a second? Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next is we have an agreement, an annual agreement that comes up for the support, some funds that we receive through the county for the senior bus. Whereas the town annually enters into a contract with the County of Orange for services to provide transportation for senior citizens to Munger Cottage and related activities, and whereas the town of Cornwall has received an amendment which modifies the January 1, 2016 agreement for vendor services between the County of Orange and the town of Cornwall, and whereas the town wishes to enter into the attached amendment to the contract, and therefore be resolved as follows, that the town board hereby agrees to enter into the amended agreement for vendor services annexed here too, and made part of this resolution and authorize the supervisor to execute the same, that a conformed copy of this resolution accompany the executed amendment returned to the county. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Second.
Moved, second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next item is on the Pilgrim Pipeline project and the Seeker. Got a lot of discussion about this. A lot of opposition to this Pilgrim Pipeline going down through the New York State Thruway property, going through many, many municipalities. And we'd just like to have the board approve this resolution that we can forward it to the appropriate agencies expressing our opposition to the pipeline. And one of the things that we're asking for is request the DEC, Conservation, and New York State Thruway Authority co-lead agencies provide a minimum 90-day comment period following the release of a draft scoping document, and further resolve that the town board requests that public information sessions and hearings be held in every county in the pipeline pathway and at least one meeting along the crude by rail route that would serve the pipelines. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved. Second.
Moved, second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. The motion is carried. Next, we have an opportunity. Carla, who chairs our Conservation Advisory Committee, had received information that the town could participate in a natural resource inventory for the community. And one of the things it recommends is, you know, combining with another community to do it. So she spoke with Mayor Coyne, and the town and the village has agreed to participate in this natural resource inventory. This is being done through the county, the New York State DEC Hudson River Estuary Program, and it's at no cost to the town. and Carla has volunteered to take the lead on it, and so it's a good opportunity for us to gather and really gain a little more information and expertise on our natural resources. So I just want a motion from the board to approve participating in this program.
So moved.
Moved by Michael, second.
Second.
Discussion, roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion is carried. I have a letter from the Department of Transportation. Pleased to announce availability of $98.7 million in funding to support transportation-related projects and programs, including bicycle, pedestrian, multi-use paths, and or projects that will help meet the requirements of the Clean Air Act by reducing congestion and vehicle emissions. Made available through the Transportation Alternatives Program, the Congestion Mitigation and Air Quality Improvement Program, the goal of this funding opportunity is to provide innovative, transformative transportation improvements for our communities, while making them safer for bicyclists, pedestrians, and motorists. Funding for projects will be awarded through a competitive solicitation process. Prospective projects will be rated based on established criteria that include public benefit, air quality improvements, and innovation. To expedite the application process for this solicitation, New York State Department of Transportation is committed to working with you or your staff. So this is available for us to look at, refer to the appropriate committees. And Michael, I know you've been working on some of that. So if you want to take a look at it and make a recommendation to the board, certainly would be
open to it. Yeah.
Okay. Next, I have a letter from Senator Larkin. Our Highway Superintendent, Eugene Conley, took the initiative to contact Senator Larkin and request a grant in the amount of $135,000 for the Town of Cornwall's Highway and Sanitation Departments to purchase two heavy trucks and a diesel roller. The funding is through the State Municipal Facilities Program and be administered by the Dormitory Authority. And I'm pleased to announce that Eugene received a letter from Senator Larkin indicating that the town will receive $135,000. Very timely, Eugene presented to Carrie and I while we were discussing the budget and equipment purchases going forward. So this will help us even to accomplish some of the goals that we have with the equipment. We're trying to come up with a short range plan on purchases that we need right away, and then sort of come up with a long term plan so we can identify the needs in terms of equipment. This equipment today is expensive. These big trucks and garbage trucks, stuff used to be very reasonable before. Now it's $200,000. I think a regular garbage truck is $220,000,
$230,000. And they don't last as long.
No, and they don't last as long. So we thank the Senator for that, and we'll be looking forward to working with Eugene as we move forward on that. Community Walk Run for Cancer, a letter from Neil Wilkinson. Please accept this letter as a request for approval. The Cornwall Walk Run for Cancer to be held on Saturday, October 29th, 9:30 a.m. at Riverlight Park. This has been a popular and community-driven event in Cornwall for over 10 years. I'd like to continue to raise awareness and honor those who have struggled with the disease. I would advise Chief Hazard, Highway Superintendent Conley, and Little League President John Cornwright. Please see attached map of the 5K, 10K course. Insurance will be provided. Please find my public event permit included. And we don't have the fee for any more than considering the waiver. So sincerely, Neil Wilkinson. Is there a motion to approve the event?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next are just really routine budget adjustments between categories and we've got the list that the board has been provided with. Is there a motion to approve the budget adjustments?
So moved.
Second.
Move second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. We have a license application, new application for a liquor license for Spy Rock LLC, Storm King Tavern, 18 Ridge Road, which I think we indicated was a Storm King golf course.
Yes.
So we just have to note that for the record. There's no action that's required by the board.
The board has 30 days in which to object if it wishes to object to the liquor license. If you have no objections, you just don't do anything.
Okay. No objections, I assume. Okay. Town of New Windsor sent us some proposed zoning changes, and Mr. Gaba looked through the zoning changes and identified through the tax map the areas. Subsequent to that, I was in touch with New Windsor, and we find that the proposed changes are not really near, and I think they did this as a courtesy. They weren't required to even send it to the town. Mm-hmm. But they're basically taking what I think is now planned industrial?
Yeah, they're industrial downzoning uses. It's called like industrial business.
Just to a highway commercial. And the area is located 94 up behind the Price Chopper area, and it's a piece that goes up to Mertz Lane and cuts over. And so that's what they're looking to just go to a highway commercial. So read a resolution, whereas the town clerk and town of Cornwall received the notice from the town of New Windsor attorney regarding proposed changes in New Windsor's zoning laws, whereas the town board has reviewed the proposed zoning amendments, and therefore be resolved as follows. Town board has no objection to the zoning amendments, and as such, does not wish to take any action regarding the same. Is there a motion? Is there a second? Sorry. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. I have a request from the building inspector, request permission to attend the 3-day training seminar to be held in Kingston, November 2nd to November 4th. I'm specifically need a 9-hour 2016 energy code update that's being offered. Registration fee is $325, paid by October 15th. Lodging will not be required as I plan on commuting daily. Funds have been allocated in training budget this year. Thank the board for their consideration. Respectfully, Gary A. Vincent, Building Inspector. Is there a motion to approve the training?
So moved.
Moved by Helen, second.
Second.
Peter? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next, I have a resignation. The police chief submitted a resignation. Part-time dispatcher John Galimas resigned as part-time dispatcher effective August 26th, 2016. Is there a motion to accept the resignation?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
It was a little confusing because it said part-time building inspector.
Rita?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So is that what it?
I was just wondering.
It says building inspector.
Oh, no. It.
Is
yeah, you're right.
One?
You're right.
Is
no, it was part-time. One? Yeah, it should be dispatcher. Yeah, it's okay. Just the one.
Okay.
Police dispatcher, correct?
Police yes. Dispatcher, correct. Okay, did we do roll call?
No, we did not. Mr. Russell?
Yes, for the police dispatcher.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
And Mr. Randez?
Yes, motion is carried. And the next appointments that we're going to make, Councilwoman Bunt is our liaison to senior citizens. And she's been scouring the area, and we wanted to get a senior advisory committee back up and running. We had one a few years ago, and really as an opportunity to really get some input from our seniors as to some of the activities and things that they would like to see in the community and help us put together some plans. So we have Betty Jurgens, Betty Longinot, Al Mazzocca, and Ann Keegan recommended for appointment to the senior advisory committee. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Move the second. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes.
And they are all with us.
They are all with us in the audience. And we thank you very much. Okay, the only thing I added was the Chamber Fall Festival is Sunday, the 18th.
Mm-hmm.
And Sands Ring Homestead is going to be open for tours and information.
Yes, from 12 to 4.
From 12 to 4. So we invite the public who may come to Cornwall for the festivities to, if they have the opportunity, to stop by the Sands Ring and take a tour of the building. So we have committee reports. Councilwoman Bunt.
Well, for COVAC, we're still doing our negotiations or whatever you call it, right?
Yeah, I think, and to expand on that, I think, you know, the board has been spending considerable time reviewing future contract with COVAC, and we are at the point of finalizing the proposal that we would like to make to COVAC. The ultimate goal, two ultimate goals. Number one is to make sure that we have a high level of EMS service in our community, and secondly, to do this in a way that will allow COVAC to go out on their own as an entity providing EMS service to the community. So we will be meeting with COVAC very shortly to go over the contract and hopefully be able to move forward with that.
And the building department report is permits issued 23, CCs issued 19, CO 6, on-site inspection 62, complaints investigated 3, one-stop work order, 5 notice of violations, 12 fire inspections, 7 signs have been removed, permit fees $3,100, permit renewal fees $200, fees for municipal searches $5,400. So, can I have this copy back?
Yes.
Because it has the stuff attached to it.
Okay. Councilman Summerfield?
The Conservation Committee was supposed to meet last Wednesday, but there, because of scheduling problems, we are not meeting until tomorrow. So there's nothing to say in regards to the Conservation Committee. The EDAC met on Thursday, August 25th. We met with Mary Lou from the library, and there's an upcoming economic forum or a discussion about economic developments in Cornwall at the library on Wednesday, September 28th at 6:30 p.m. The public is welcome, and we'll look forward to having a number of the Economic Development Committee members present, as well as Supervisor Randazzo and Mayor Coyne. So if you can find room in your schedule, please come out. The remainder of the meeting was principally about reviewing the clean copy of the mission statement. I'm sure they'll all be pleased that they now have a mission, and we'll look forward to making a presentation or having a discussion at some future point, maybe at the next work session.
Okay.
And that's all I have.
Okay. Councilor Russell?
For sewer, for the first plant on top of routine maintenance, all measured parameters were within permit limits. And for Shore Road, on top of routine maintenance, again, all measured parameters were within permit limits. So that's good. That's both for August of 2016. For recreation, upcoming trips, Mohegan Sun, Connecticut, Tuesday, October 18th. Anyone who's interested, the price is $35. There's a trip on Thursday, October 27th to the Broadway, Westchester Broadway Theater. However, the trip is full, but they are taking names for a waiting list. Upcoming classes at Tennis Club, September 14th through October 12th. It's for 3-, 4-, and 5-year-olds, first and second graders, and third and fourth graders. And then there's PIYO in the park at Laurel Crest. I'm not even sure what the acronym stands for. September 20th through October 27th. I have to call Recreation to find out what they're offering. There it is, 12 sessions starting September 20th. The final numbers for the pool, for the waiting pool, the overall total was 2,372 customers. And for the full-size pool, the overall total was 5,019 for the season. So those good numbers for a lot of use of our pools. For the police department, for August 2016, there were 786 calls for service. There were 29 motor vehicle accidents reported, 23 alarms, that's residential and business alarms, 21 requests for ambulances, 11 animal complaints, 15 disabled vehicles were reported, 29 house checks were, courtesy checks were conducted, and 28 assists of other agencies, and no other reports from the police department. That's it.
I just want to comment one thing on the pool. Of course, we've had the leaks in the pool that always seemed to be there, and work that was done. But after the pool closed this season, we did have a leak detection company come in to try to sort of identify where the areas might be. And right now, we're very suspect that, I think around 2003, small sections of the concrete deck were cut out, and pipes that feed the pool were replaced. And it seemed that that's where the leaks were coming from. Two of them were pretty bad. So we are going to take up one section of that and just check the type of pipe and see if the pipe has failed. If it does, that's good news, even though we're going to have to pay to fix it. But if that's really the source of our loss of so much water, then it really will improve the facility and lower our costs next year in terms of operating. So I'll let the board know once we do that. So, Councilman McGinnis?
Highway department worked on the town basin at golf, on town basin at golf course, and cleaned up from flooding. You remember the storm. Clean Robert Road area from heavy rainstorm, clean up rain garden from flooding, same storm. Clean and check basins townwide, work with sanitation department, sweeper out of town wide cleaning streets. Prep roads for oil and chip work, chip sealed roads in town as per 5-year plan, and patched roads with hot mix asphalt. Did roadside mowing and string trimming townwide. Also under the highway department, the town of Highlands is anticipated tonight to declare an above ground 2,000 gallon gas tank that their highway department was using. The highway department ceased to fuel their trucks from an on-site tank and issue credit cards to all of their employees. And the highway superintendent has offered it to the town of Cornwall Highway Department for a dollar. It's sitting on a trailer and he will deliver it. I talked to the supervisor this afternoon and he suggested that we have our engineer look at the tank and or at least the documents and see what would be required if we wanted to accept this gift and stage it at our highway department. One of the benefits would be that our underground tank now, of course, is always a liability. The DEC does not like underground tanks. Mm-hmm. And it's only 1,000 gallons. This is 2,000 gallons. And it would be cheaper for us to fill a larger tank or charge the surcharge for 1,000 gallon deliveries. So I suggest that we consider it and have our engineer look at it.
Yeah, I think the one thing that jumped out at me, in all honesty, was that the tank is a 1995 tank. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I just think that we have to run it by our engineer to make sure DEC
issues. It looks brand new.
Yeah. I've seen some cars like that. They look brand new. But no, I think, listen, if it's something that would work out, but I think, you know, it would be smart for us to have the engineer look at it in terms of the DEC requirements and all that.
And it's probably
what Highland Pools got rid of it and what they're doing. Is that a better
what?
Plan?
Why did they get rid of it?
No, go to the plan Highland Pools. What are they doing for their gas?
No. Credit cards for everybody.
Oh, it's expensive.
Well, there's also a difference. I mean, we buy gas at much lower, I think, than what you can buy in the market.
Paying a lot less than you would at a gas station.
So, but I'd like to entertain a motion to refer that to the engineer for a report as soon as he can get it back to us, so we'll have some idea.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call?
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rangers?
Yes. Motion is carried. Carrie, anything further?
The assessor's office.
Right.
We're at a crucial point in our data entry, and in order to generate our mailers that will be going out shortly, we're confident that we will meet our target dates, and we've had the cooperation of the county, who has provided several employees that are continuing to work with our employees to finish up entering the data so that we can move on to the next step.
2,000 units went out Thursday.
Yes, the village, actually the data mailers went out to the village.
Right.
And I think what we're going to be doing is sending part of the town out next and then the final part after all the data is put in all. So hopefully that's going to help keep us on track so we can continue to move forward.
I just want to point out I've received mine already, and you should review it, and there's a timeline when you have to, if there's any errors on there, you mail it back in.
You're right. You can't stress the fact that the data mailer is really important for the property owner, because that's an ideal time for you to look at the data that's on file here, and if it's not correct, your assessment may not be correct. So it's important to look at it. If you have any concerns, questions, get them back into the to the assessor's office, and it'll be reviewed. So, okay, we have warrant number 9.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion, roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. Beginnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Public comment? Yes, Liz.
Yes. Elizabeth Helwich, Vice President of the Cornwall Public Library Board of Trustees. This item was in your work session, but I don't see it on tonight's agenda. So I just wanted to check with the board that you're all in receipt of Janine Bixler's letter from the library board. So I just wanted to come and reiterate that the library board would like to be a part of any decision for the historical society or a placement of artifacts. We were a little taken back that you were considering putting up a building and utilizing our parking without having a discussion with us.
I don't know where you got the idea that we're looking to utilize your parking.
Yeah.
This is not even on the same level as the library. So you have misinformation then, Liz.
Okay.
Yeah, that's there's no way that this building, if it goes where we propose it and if we go through with it, there's no way that it really infringes in any way on the library property at all. It's on town property.
Okay.
We will have some parking spaces that will be put by the building. And then, of course, we have the parking lot for Munger Cottage and every place that Little League uses to park all over the grass. So there was never, I don't know where it came from, but it's totally incorrect to think that we were going to plan on using your park, because quite honestly, you don't have enough parking as it is in
right.
many instances when you have programs going.
Right.
So that really is misinformation that you have. But
we'd like to be part of a discussion of any such building this week.
Yeah. No. And we'll be happy to do that. Right now, it's only gotten as far as the engineer sort of doing a site sketch of it. We're waiting for the engineer to come back to the town with just a general cost estimate of what the building might cost. But that's as far as it's going at this point. So once we get that information, we're going to make it public. The board will be discussing it, and anyone who wants to have input will be welcome to have input.
Well, it kind of seems to us that that's quite an investment of time and effort into something before considering existing spaces, such as the refurbished Sam's Ring or Munger Cottage.
Yeah. Well, I saw that in your letter, and I figured I was going to be over there on the 28th or whenever the meeting is.
Okay.
But, I mean, two things. Number one, the Sands Ring Homestead is a museum for a period in time. It is not for a historical museum in terms of putting other items, town items and everything else. It's something where people can go there and experience the 1760
right.
experience. So that is not the place. And Munger Cottage is used regularly for meetings, and we have a contract with the county for the nutrition and all. So, you know, I mean, we're not operating, you know, in a vacuum. We understand what facilities we have and what can be used. So when the time comes, we can have a discussion. We can lay out the details of it. And it's not a great investment to have the engineer give us a cost estimate just to give the board an idea. And I will emphasize this. We are looking for a very simple, inexpensive building that will provide square footage to be able to display the artifacts that we do have and all, and we are hoping to keep the cost at an absolute minimum. So, and just to comment further, since we're on the subject, I mean, I know part of the interest was, well, maybe it should be put in, the library wants to expand, maybe it should be in there. I've got to be honest with you, I would believe, and we'll know this when the year comes, but for us to put up a simple frame building, primarily for square footage, is going to be much less cost to the town than taking up space in a library, which generally goes for much more per square foot than this building that we've been. And we're even looking, considering prefab for the building. That's how inexpensive we really want the building to be. We just want square footage for display. So, but I'm happy, we're happy to talk to you.
Okay. Well, because you were talking about volunteer staffing.
Yeah.
And
the truth is, I think if we did have our own building, you know, once you get a facility that's really adequate and all, you tend to get more volunteers too, who are willing to put in time and something as opposed to being jammed into one room or so up on the second floor. So, but I think we'll be open for any discussion.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much. Anyone else? Okay, I'd like to...
Go ahead. For yesterday's ceremony, thank the fire department.
Yes.
Jerry McGinnis for putting together a very moving ceremony yesterday at the 9/11 memorial.
Very well done. Well attended. Yes. Well attended. It really was. And, you know, it's that moment in time where you know, you just draw on your patriotism and just be thankful that we live in a country that we live in with so many people who are willing to step up and do what has to be done to keep us safe.
And the other point that I made it yesterday, there was many kids at the ceremony. Mm-hmm. And if you think about it, it's been 15 years. A child would have to be a junior in high school or older to even be born when 9/11 took place. Right. And there was a lot of participation from children, from Boy Scouts. I believe Girl Scouts were there and gym kids. It was nice.
It was very nice.
Very nice.
Thank you. Okay, I'd like to have a motion for the board to go into executive session to discuss personnel, the employment of a particular person, and close session to seek the advice of counsel.
Second.
Move, second, discussion, roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield? Yes. Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion is carried. Thank you very much.
Will we take action?
I don't believe so.
Okay.